Rittenhouse allegedly shot and killed two people. You know what officers did? He was carrying an assault weapon. The video shows the police shared water with him and thanked him for his presence. Also, after the shooting, he was able to leave the scene. Even though caught on video, he walked towards police with his hands up as protesters yelled that he had shot people.
By now, we've all seen Kyle Rittenhouse crying at his trial and the judge acting like his defense attorney. His crocodile tears has conservatives everywhere talking about how he's just a young child with PTSD, including Mr. Facts Don't Care About Your Feelings, Ben Shapiro, who has been retweeting sentiments like this all day. As you can see, we have this Noam Bloom character up here thinking that he's making a point by saying that Black people are hypocritical because if Kyle was Black, the Black community would be in support of him instead of against him in this trial. This is obviously a dig at the sentiments of the BLM movement, that people who support Black victims of police brutality are actually just in support of criminals, because every single victim of police brutality who's Black somehow deserved it. But that's the thing. The BLM movement wasn't saying that every single victim was completely innocent. It was saying that every single victim deserves their fair day in court, not just to be massacred on the street by a cop playing judge, jury, and executioner. The beginning of this clip started with Sunny Hostin of The View talking about Micaiah Bryant and how she was shot on the spot by police despite being the one to call them because people had come to her home intending to attack her. According to conservatives, Micaiah Bryant was not a kid and therefore deserved her fate at the hands of the police. And now those same conservatives are babying Kyle Rittenhouse, despite the fact that he traveled to Wisconsin with a military-style weapon with the premeditated intent to hunt people. There are two takeaways from this. Number one, white supremacy will always use weaponized incompetence in order to escape accountability. That's what those tears were for. The same tears that have played a role in the demise of people like Emmett Till. Second, Kyle Rittenhouse acted as a vigilante on behalf of the state. That's why he's being babied. The police are not here to serve and protect human beings. They're here to protect order and property. They are the foot soldiers of the state, and that's why they will crack down on protesters who have anti-government sentiments. This is why they always have to call protesters rioters, to manufacture your consent for a military crackdown, and to justify the existence of vigilantes like Rittenhouse, who helped them get the job done